Okay, now here comes the hardest concept thus far. The hardest one thus far. Validity. Valid versus invalid deductive argument. So valid deductive arguments are ones that are successful in being deductive in the following way. Deductive arguments are shooting for certainty. Valid deductive arguments succeed in certainty. So valid deductive arguments are arguments for which it is impossible for the conclusion to be false on the basis that the premises are true. However, an invalid deductive argument is going to be an argument which is, it is possible for the conclusion to be false on the basis that the premises are true. So the key difference here is deductive arguments, there's an attempt. If the premises are true, the conclusion must be true. Valid deductive arguments, there's full support. Invalid deductive arguments are ones which are shooting for a guarantee, but they don't actually give it to you. So it's possible the conclusion could be false when the premises are true. So the definition of validity. A deductive argument is valid. It has the quality of being valid if and only if it is not possible that the premises are true and the conclusion false. Or, if the premises are true, the conclusion must be true. Now notice, this says nothing. This says nothing about whether or not the premises are in fact true. But it's saying something else. It's saying if they're true, then something else follows. If, it's a conditional claim. It's not saying the conclusion is true. It's not saying the premises are true. It's saying if the premises are true, the conclusion must be true. It's asserting a relationship between the premises and the conclusion. It's not saying something about the way the world is, in fact. Conversely, the definition of invalidity is a deductive argument is invalid if and only if it's possible, if it is possible, that the premises be true and the conclusion false. It's allowing that this relationship deteriorate in the following way. The premises can be true and the conclusion can be false while the premises are true. So some deductive arguments that are valid or invalid. We evaluate this in terms of the form or the structure of an argument. Does not have to do with whether the premises are realistic or not. So all cats have a scruff on their neck. Molly is a cat. Therefore, Molly has a scruff on the neck. All bullfrogs are born in water. Jeremiah was a bullfrog. He was a good friend of mine. Anyway, therefore, Jeremiah was born in the water. Or you could think abstractly, the form of an argument and just ignore what it's talking about, that is its content. All A's are B. This thing is an A, therefore this thing is a B. We're relating two groups. A's are in the group of B. This thing is a member of the first group, so then it has to be a member of the second group. That's the structure of both of these two arguments. And the structure is the same even if it's talking about my Molly cat or about Jeremiah the bullfrog. The structure is the same, or the form is the same, and so that means that we can kind of like ignore what the argument's talking about and just think about how do the premises relate to the conclusion. That has to do with its structure. It doesn't have to do with cats or bullfrogs. So, if all triangles are three-sided, then they have 180 degrees. Triangles are three-sided. Then, conclusion, they have 180 degrees. Or Sarah likes apples, only if they are peeled. Sarah likes these apples right here, so these apples are peeled. We can abstract the structure of these two arguments as having basically the same structure too. If we ignore talking about triangles or about apples and things like that, we can just see that the structure is if A, then B. structure of the first argument and the second argument are the same. They have this more abstract version here. And so if you know one argument is good, then the other argument is good too, at least in terms of support, which is the whole thing that we're trying to evaluate with deduction and validity. So if we've abstracted the form of an argument, we can plug in anything for it. We could have whatever content we want to fill in for A's or B's, and the argument will still work in terms of support. We don't care about whether the premises are true. We're just talking about if the premises are true, what does it tell us about the conclusion? So consider these two arguments. All apples are fruit. This gala is an apple. Therefore, this is a fruit. Pretty straightforward. It's got the same structure as the first one, but so is the one on the right. All cows are purple. Bessie is a cow. Therefore, Bessie is purple. Now, even if all cows are not purple, or not all cows are purple, this argument still has the same structure. So that means that they're all going to have like the same kind of support relationship to the conclusion. All rabbits are made of wood. This jack pine is a rabbit. Therefore, this pine is made of wood. Notice, in all of these cases, I don't care whether the premises are true or not. I don't care whether the conclusion is true or not. All I care about is the relationship the premises have to the conclusion. Because for this first argument, all apples are fruit, the premises are true, and the conclusion's true. For the second argument on the right, all cows are purple, Bessie is a cow, it's just not realistic. Premise one is false. And the conclusion's false. So if I'm going to be evaluating the structure of the argument, I'm not going to be asking whether the premises are true or whether the conclusion's true. I'm going to be assessing how do they relate. After all, this third argument, the premises are both false. All jackrabbits are not made of wood. This jack pine is not a rabbit. That's nonsense. But the conclusion happens to be true. This pine is made of wood. So, what we're evaluating is the structure of how the premises give support to the conclusion. All of these arguments are valid. They're all valid. If the premises are true, or if they were true, the conclusion would have to be true. If I imagine a world where all the cows are purple and I find this animal, Bessie, is a cow, then in that world, Bessie is purple. It might be helpful to be thinking of fictional scenarios like that, because it helps you see the relationship between these different claims. So the form of the argument is going to be valid. So that means any argument that has the same exact form is also going to be valid. Doesn't matter what they're talking about. Validity is assessed by its form or its structure, not by its content. And again, they're all valid because of the relationship the premises have to conclusion. If the premises are true, the conclusion would or must be true. Not just probably true, but guaranteed to be true. So, after abstracting the form of an argument, we can plug in anything, right? So, all cats have hearts. All cats have kidneys. All things that have hearts also have kidneys. Is this a good argument? Well, if the premises are true, does the conclusion have to be true? Well, it turns out the premises are true and the conclusion's true. But it's an accident. Because if we ignore its content and just look at its structure, all A's have attribute B, all A's have this other attribute C, can you conclude that anything that has the property of B also has C? No. All bullfrogs are born in water. All bullfrogs are amphibian. Therefore, all things born in water are amphibian? No, dolphins are born in water, but they're not an amphibian. Pike are born in water, but they're not amphibian. So the argument structure sucks. It's invalid. The premises can't give you the conclusion. Even though it's aiming for a guarantee, it fails to give you what it's trying to do. You can have the premises both be true and the conclusion false. And since all of these arguments on this page have the same structure, If one of them you can show to have true premises and the conclusion false, then that means the structure is the problem. The structure is the problem. And if the structure is the problem, then any argument that you plug in to that same structure, whether you're talking about cats or bullfrogs or triangles or whatever, it's also going to have a bad structure too. Doesn't matter what you plug in. If the conclusion's true, it's only by accident. So it's possible for the premises to be true and the conclusion's false. So the argument form here is invalid. And I've shown this by coming up with a counterexample, an argument that has the same structure, but I plugged in the right kind of information to make it obvious that even if the premises are true, it doesn't mean the conclusion's true, as I showed with all things born in water are amphibian. That claim is just false. So as a matter of review, valid deductive arguments are arguments for which it is impossible the conclusion to be false on the basis that the premises are true. It doesn't say anything about whether the conclusion's true. It doesn't say anything about whether the premises are true. It just means that the premises fully support the conclusion. You can get there from here. If the conclusion's false, then you know something, right? If the conclusion's false for a valid argument, then you gotta say one of the premises is the reason it's false. If you've got a valid argument and the conclusion's false, then what happened was you got a premise that was wrong. It was false itself. However, invalid arguments are arguments for which it is possible for the conclusion to be false on the basis that the premises are true. It doesn't mean that the conclusion is in fact false. You could get an invalid argument could get a conclusion right, but it's by accident. It doesn't have to be true. It doesn't have to be false. It can be false. This only means that the premises don't fully support the conclusion. You can't actually conclude what is said to be a conclusion from the pieces of information that you started with, the premises. It's invalid. So if the conclusion is false, it could just be that you're unlucky. The invalid argument is just unlucky. You started with some premises that are true, but the structure was bad, so of course you didn't have a conclusion guaranteed. You weren't lucky. This is a notoriously hard concept. If you don't get this portion of the text right away, you're not alone. You're not alone. Please know that you and many of your classmates will also struggle with this issue. Part of what we'll do is we'll get better at it by exposure to arguments that are valid and invalid and seeing why the argument does or doesn't work. So this is a notoriously hard concept. I recommend rewatching the lecture, looking at the examples over again, and working through some practice exercises as well, just to try to familiarize yourself what's going on and what's wrong. This is a notoriously hard concept. Somebody could take a logic class, know the definition, and have a hard time applying it because they haven't actually had it click. It's okay to have this take a little while for you to sort it out and have it like sink in what the concept of validity means. For some of you, it's been straightforward. For others, it's not there yet, and that's okay. Got to work through it a little bit more.